And I would ask that if anybody has any information about my twin brother Bradley Kay, please call the number on the poster, 1-855-4-BRADLEY-TIPS. Thank you.
For those who saw my January live stream, you would have seen my reaction to Gone Girl being selected. I'd never heard of it despite its 2014 release date, its critical acclaim, and the trailer was intriguing. Gone Girl stars Ben Affleck, Neil Patrick Harris, and Rosamund Pike, and is based on the novel of the same name, released just 2 years before. That's all I can really add to the intro, so let's not waste any time and get started. Here's my review of Gone Girl. It's Nick and Amy's 5th year anniversary, but all is not well. Nick is complaining to his twin sister Margot about how he and Amy have drifted apart and how he is struggling to get her a wood-based gift. When Nick gets home, he finds the house disturbed and his wife missing. After calling the police, they investigate the house with forensics whilst Nick stays with his sister. Initially, the police, led by Detective Rhonda Boney, don't suspect Nick, but between Nick's money problems, cleaned up blood on the kitchen floor, and the fact that the scene appears to be staged, Nick quickly becomes a suspect. The town too start to turn on him as Nick doesn't know how to handle himself in public, showing up in photos, smiling, and apparently not knowing about Amy's pregnancy, her best friend, or what she does all day. Amy is loved by the town, being the inspiration for her mother's series of books called Amazing Amy, and being a writer herself. The police become more interested in Nick when they find Amy's diary, which paints him as someone who in recent years has become a shell of himself and abusive towards Amy, which he denies further. Margot sticks by Nick, even after discovering that Nick has been sleeping with one of his college students, Andy, and was planning to leave Amy, even though this would leave him with no money as he signed a prenup. Nick hires a lawyer, Tanner Bolt, and they investigate Amy's exes as Nick believes that she is still alive and framing him for her murder based on a scavenger hunt she left him, which the police are aware of. One of Amy's exes, Tommy, states that she framed him for rape, but he avoided prison by admitting to sexual assault, which has still ruined his life. The other ex, Desi, is said to have been a stalker, but he refuses to speak to Nick. Under advisement from Tanner, Nick is about to conduct an interview on TV to confess to the adultery and to try and make himself look good, as he's been torn apart by a cable show hosted by Ellen Abbott. Just before the interview though, Andy holds a press conference to tell everyone about the affair, but Nick insists on still doing the show and actually comes off well, but when returning home is arrested as they found the murder weapon, a bat with Amy's blood on it hiding in a recently used fireplace in July. Tanner gets Nick out on bail, and to everyone's amazement, Amy returns covered in blood. Okay, so Amy did frame Nick for her murder and planned it months in advance. She faked her pregnancy, faked her friends, and wrote a fake diary to make Nick look more guilty. She also ran up tons of credit card debt in Nick's name and increased her life insurance payment to give Nick a motive. She staged the scene to look slightly unrealistic and even opened a vein to bleed all over the kitchen floor and clean it badly, plus leave her blood on the murder weapon. Amy was sick of the man Nick had become and knew about the affair. She has a plan to make Nick look even more guilty, which includes killing herself so her body shows up in the river. This plan starts with her hiding out at a campground and befriending her neighbours. They watch the cable show tear Nick apart, and Amy's plan goes well until her neighbours discovered her secret stash of cash and rob her. Amy, now broke, calls Desi, her ex, who rather than being a stalker, is still obsessed with her and agrees to hide her in his lake house, believing her to be an abuse victim of Nick and happy to see him go to jail, even if he didn't actually kill her. Desi gives Amy everything she wants, but this also includes being holed up in a lake house with security cameras by every entrance and exit. Desi is clearly enamored with Amy, but doesn't push himself on her. Amy, though, is planning her escape and fakes being raped and assaulted by Desi for weeks before finally, after she seduced him, she slits his throat during sex. She then steals his car and drives home. Nick worked out that Amy framed him a while back when he solved the scavenger hunt and wanted to leave her even more, but Amy knows how to manipulate the police, with only Detective Boney being suspicious, and the press, basically trapping Nick or he will be perceived as the bad guy, leaving the victim of rape and kidnapped shortly after she returns home. Despite in public Nick and Amy looking like a united front, they're actually really distant at home, with Nick building up the courage and waiting for enough time to pass to leave her. Amy, however, managed to impregnate herself with an old sperm sample of Nick's when he sent it to a fertility clinic. Nick realizes now he's locked into this marriage, as he will help raise the child, and he just can't leave a pregnant kidnapping and rape victim. Margot is distraught that Nick is trapped, but later that day, when Nick and Amy are interviewed on the Ellen Abbott show, they announce the pregnancy. Okay, cards on the table here. Gone Girl is amazing. It is one of the best films I've reviewed in the Film Review Open Challenge so far. It's not perfect by any means, but the positives way outweigh the negatives. My plot summary split the story in half, but in actual fact, we cut between Nick and Amy all the way through. In the first hour, it flits between Nick in the present and Amy's diary entries, and at the hour mark, Amy is shown as alive, and then the film flits between Amy hiding out in the caravan park and the lake house, and Nick defending himself, now knowing that Amy is alive and framing him. The layout is really clever and not at all distracting, something that films changing perspectives can easily do. The plot twist does a lot more than just change the way the story is told. It changes your opinion completely in one cool girl monologue. Nick is firstly shown as being innocent, but then the evidence starts to build up. The motives become clearer, but also Nick is shown to not be the nice guy he appeared at the beginning. It's about 5 minutes of character assassination from concerned husband to cheating spouse with money problems. It was distracting at the time how quickly this was done, but considering how much information had to be relayed before that 1 hour mark, it's not only forgivable, but very well executed. No one is innocent here. If this was a Reddit thread, I think the answer would be ESA. That's an obscure reference. Ben Affleck plays Nick and does a serviceable job. Nothing outstanding by any means, but he doesn't let the side down. I feel Carrie Coon as Margot does a great job though, often saying what the audience is thinking, especially as more and more information is brought up. By far and away though, the performance of Rosamund Pike is outstanding. She steals the show by being a victim, sadistic, cold, calculating, and very clever. There are looks in her eyes which tell you more than words could, and indeed, she was nominated for the Best Actress Oscar, losing out to Julianne Moore. Pike goes from Bond girl to Gone Girl, and her performance is so good that by the end, you may very well be saying,
"What's an Affleck?"
Neil Patrick Harris is the only other notable performance, a lot more subdued than he normally is. I'd do a bit here where I'd use a clip from How I Met Your Mother, but honest trailers beat me to it. This obsessive and almost creepy performance though really makes me want to see Harris in a more sinister role, something akin to Robin Williams in 1 Hour Photo. I reacted to the trailer on my livestream and it filled me with intrigue. It makes you think that this is about Nick, a crime thriller, but no, this is all about Amy. The flashbacks, which turn out to be a mixture of reality and fiction, the clever plan to frame Nick, Amy's plan to destroy him, and then the manipulation and escape from Desi. There are little things that Amy does to make sure this plan pulls off, things like hitting herself in the face with a hammer to make it look like she's been beaten up, or faking rape with a wine bottle. It's stuff that really makes you cringe and shows that she's committed to the bit. The plan isn't foolproof. Surely a postmortem would show that she wasn't or was ever pregnant. Not to mention the fact that she changed her hair length and colour. And finally, how exactly would finding her body months later, when Nick is supposed to have killed her right away, line up? The little details are well thought out, but perhaps missing the bigger picture. If she killed herself right away, then some of these problems wouldn't have been brought up. I also don't like how easily Desi is fooled. Not initially, but later on when Amy is supposedly concerned for her safety. Why wouldn't he check the security footage and then ask Amy why she's faking abuse? He's also very happy to see Nick go to jail for something he didn't do, which isn't really a great character trait. I get it, he's besotted and always has been, but it strikes me as a common sense oversight. In some ways, maybe Amy wanted to be caught. It's the same mentality as the Riddler from Batman, leaving clues so everyone can see how clever she is. The only time Amy is shown as vulnerable, except when it's not an excerpt from her fake diary, it's when she's robbed of her money, which ruins her plans and leaves her desperate enough to call Desi. For a film that goes nearly 3 hours, Gone Girl certainly grips you, and this is mainly because of the way the film seems to be split into three acts with an epilogue. It could quite easily have been a TV series, albeit quite a short one. The movie feels long, but there's also a lot of information without bogging you down with it. Again, a very hard balance to get right. There's quite a debate over whether the film is misogynistic or feminist, and I don't really feel that it's either. Not all women are shown to be one way or the other. Some are the victim, some are the antagonist. So why does it need to have one of these labels? For me, I enjoyed a film with a clever victim, a story that captivates, and acting that is to be admired. It may make me one-dimensional, but that's just how I saw it. As a result, I can recommend Gone Girl as a thriller, which does nearly everything well. I love the rollercoaster of not knowing who to root for, which way it goes, and the fact that you may never look at the missing person's case in the same way again. There's not much I'd change in this film, and I'll definitely watch this again sometime. Gone Girl will not be gone from my memory anytime soon. Coming up next for the film review open challenge is The Nun. For now though, thank you very much for watching.